get around All-Star break and come out. It's been such a long season up to that point. It's like you're trying to gather your breath and you have a little change. But like you said, Brian, the focus is here.
We've had some big wins in between as well. A massive game against Denver. Great win in Phoenix that was shorthanded. Šamanić inside lays it in for the game's first bucket. James Harden back out there. Has been dealing with a sore right foot. Looks okay there as he lobs it to Ivica Zubac, and the Clippers get on the board. Zu has played maybe some of his best basketball as a Clipper. And that's it.
And now it's just commonplace when James and Zubac get into it. And it's funny, like that jump shot coming off of Zubac on the screen.
By the way, not to dampen the drama here, Jim Jackson, the Dallas Mavericks lost earlier tonight. It is official. P.J. Tucker.
And he gets like, back to Paul George.
It's like watching the final brushstrokes of the Mona Lisa.
See, Paul George did one and two. So what he got was...
They had the home court back in 2021. Unfortunately, they did win the Game 7. They were playing in front of cardboard cutouts as Paul George misses a three. Oh, it's a big finish from Terrence Mann. Puts the Clippers out in front by 11. That's Buzzard's luck that has happened that was out of everyone's control.
Yep.
Keontae George to Taylor Hendricks. The rookie misfires. Šamanić inside. Counted and a foul. As fun of a game as you'll see in a losing effort, given that there was not really that much on the line for the Clippers. Lazu punishes inside. Ivica Zubac puts the Clippers out in front by 10. Kenny Lofton Jr. is out there, spent some time with Memphis. He's put up some big numbers in games late in the season. Baisley played well in that game last week for Utah.
Tucker's in the game, and he extends 2 to 3 possessions for your offense because of outstanding hustle like that. That's invaluable.
I could see him playing in 2 to 3 minutes. Yeah, 10 points in the entire season up into that point. Zoo inside. Feathery floater is good for Ivica Zubac. He's got 8.
I'd like to thank myself. I know JC wouldn't do it for kind of raising that young man the right way, how to be professional after your career. So.
Lofton beats Westbrook. Count it and a foul. And that'll send us to break. In the corner to Powell, driven off the line by Horton Tucker. A nice reverse layup as a wave of defenders crash behind him. I think you're calling for a challenge.
We better have one challenge today so we can see the great Bill Kennedy go to.
Powell unable to get that one to fall. Powell 1 for 4. Clippers lead 43-39. They've led by as many as 15. Kenny Lofton Jr. coming in with some nice minutes. He's got...
So they weren't really matched up on Lofton. Quick move by... See, and that's where you got to respect about Bones Hyland. Like, we see it with Russ. Hey, dude.
Response. Keontae George to Lofton. Hit it from the spot just a moment ago and does it again. 20 points for Lofton.
Living it, doing it, and everyone has. I mean, even during the stretch, you know, James's usage rate was the lowest it was since, you know, his first 2 years at Oklahoma City. Kawhi, same thing. Not as many pick and rolls. Is
it? A different here for the Clippers in this quarter. 15 to 25, you like that one right there. 4 for 9 for 3 in the first. That one now brings us to
a Phoenix team that needed the win to kind of stay in the hunt for a top 6 spot in the Western Conference. But some wild things happening tonight, maybe just from afar. Hyland tries to beat the buzzer here. Now it's Coffee for 3. And Ty said, is Tice able to lay it in? I asked him when he was a player, their last 8 shots, the minute to play here.
There you go. Get to the basket.
Coffee hangs and hits.
See, that is not settling.
Did you ever pay somebody's technical?
No. Barely paid mine.
Hyland inside. 61-60. And maybe you could make the case, hey, they could be a 10 seed in the West as it shook out and kind of played on. Probably not. They decided to change gears midway through the years. And tonight, all 30 teams in action on Sunday. Nobody plays tomorrow. Yurt 7 inside with the flush. George, nice feed inside to Taylor Hendricks for the flush. Who your favorite is, you want to see the best compete against the best.
And with regards to beautiful pass by Hyland into Plumlee. with regards to Carl Anthony Towns coming back?
There's got to be some things that happen there to get the Lakers or Warriors into that other side of the play-in situation. As Bones Hyland knocks down a three.
New York.
Indiana. Indiana's been struggling a little bit. But without Julius Randle, or if he comes back, where, how will he be?
Running rebound by Plumlee. Clippers down by 11, 7:19 to play. Coffey alone in the corner for three. It is good. Amir Coffey now with 10.
Got him.
A master at coming up with mismatches and favorable matchups. Keontae George loved it the second it left his hand. Knocks down the three. George
utilizing with this unit. Oh, good defense by Kobe.
Brown takes it to the rim. Oh, he reverses it. What a big play for the youngster. Boston twisting and turning. Oh, what a shot by Boston. Knocks it down. And Brandon Boston, now that's his first field goal. He's got 4 points here. Clippers trail by that margin, 82-78. Sends the ball off the window and in. And the youngsters are taking over this game. Nice play by Moon. Great working without the ball from Boston. Gets his second bucket. Cuts the lead down to one. Baisley tries to drive on Coffey. 9 to shoot for Utah. Great footwork. Nice touch inside. 10 seconds to play in the third. On a 13-5 run to get back into this game. They've trailed by as many as 11. Moon rises from 20. Oh, it goes! It was a short stint for the starters, playing barely first quarter minutes after it was revealed that the Dallas Mavericks lost earlier, giving the Clippers the 4 seed in the West.
By the ball movement of the Clippers, you know, in that third quarter, got the lead back down, but I'm giving up two. But, you know, plagued by some early injuries, but big body, athletic. That was my Jacoby. There you go. Stay with it. But he has a bright future. He's had to figure out how to get his body right in the mirror. Coffey, you have to focus and execute the game plan. And then how many adjustments there are during the game and then for the next game.
From Preston to Lofton to Baisley. Blocked by Tice, recovered by Preston, recovered by Tice. Kobe Brown the other way. Charges in on Sensabaugh, off the window. Tice lays it up and in. It's a tie game at 96. It's a little too much for him playing against the Golden State Warriors.
Oh, yeah.
But I thought he handled it well, all things considered.
Always trying to get to the next thing. And it's easier said than done during the course of the season. So good move by Tice to get inside and hesitate. During the course of the season, we're doing so many games.
Boston! Oh, my goodness! Brandon Boston is flying high in downtown Los Angeles. Samanich gives it to Lofton Jr., knocks it down. It's a 4-point lead for Utah. 5 minutes to play in the... Hyland, a step back three. He knocks it down. We got a game.
Here we go. Down one.
Great defense by Tice. Horton Tucker figures it out, lays it up. Too strong. Rebound goes to Hyland. Clippers are down by one. Bones from the line to the lane. Oh, the skeleton crew is back. By double figures much of the second half. They've come to life here in the fourth quarter. Keontae George for three in the lead. A big shot for Utah. Kobe Brown, he hit a three earlier. A little short. And Horton Tucker with a lead pass to Lofton makes the grab. Hit it, count it, and a foul for Kenny Lofton Jr. It's now 109-105 to a cutting Hyland. Brown, nice feed to Tice, and a nice finish inside. The lead is trimmed to three. Tough shot. Rebound Tice. The Clippers have it with 9 seconds to play. No timeout coming. Moon for the lead. Boston. No whistle. Ball game. Utah holds on. What a finish. What a second half. Both teams. Phenomenal effort for the final 24 minutes.